So after I opened up this power bank in the mailbag video a little while ago, I got kind of actually excited about it. And I started putting things together before I even bothered to turn the camera on. So let's just rewind for a second. So I got this 4 18650 power bank kit. Basically frame, circuit board, aluminum case, and a little front cover plate. And I went digging around in my accumulation and found half a dozen 18650s that I'd ripped out of a Hewlett Packard laptop battery. Not that one, that's another one. So I went through and I charged them up with constant current, constant voltage power supply, similar to this one, but not quite the same. Let me see if I can dig it up here quickly. This one, these things are all over eBay, but basically you can set it for whatever current, whatever voltage, and it'll do constant current mode until it gets up to a certain voltage, and then it'll set into constant voltage mode. And then it's got one LED in here that has it's a charge complete, full. There it is, second one from the bottom there. So set it for 4.2 volts, set it for 500 milliamps, because that's 0.5 of these phone batteries that I've been dicking with. These things are probably quite a bit higher, but doesn't hurt you to charge them a little bit lower rate. I mean, it takes time, but whatever. So anyway, I charged all those guys up, and they've been sitting on the shelf for about a month. So went through them and picked the four that had retained the most voltage, 3.97, 4.01, 375, 382, and these two are just a hair lower, 368 and 368. So they're not too much worse, but they are a little bit lower. So we'll go with these four. The other thing I started doing is I've got a whole big roll of this brass shim stock. It's quite thin. I don't know exactly how thick it is. Do I want to? It doesn't really matter for this. And I can't find my good set of calipers. So I'll just use this guy here and... So thin they can't even read it on that piece of crap. Ah, doesn't matter. It's thin. Whoop, 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 whoop. So I used my utility knife and the ruler there and just chopped a couple of strips off it. Then I set those guys in there, set those strips on there, and just marked where the gaps between the batteries were, and I tinned where the batteries are actually going to go. The reason I decided to use strips instead of wires to bust these together is that there just isn't room in there for wires. So a couple of strips, that one should go down there quite nicely, and there's room in there for that one, and I can still tag a wire off them. So that's going to be the next thing, I guess, is to solder those together. Now then, how do I maintain the spacing while I'm doing this? I guess I'll just tape them together. They're pretty much touching anyway, so it doesn't matter that much. This is an experiment. I'm doing this on the fly. There we go. So those were tabbed and soldered, or spot welded, I guess, into their former life. Not going to need that here. But how's my iron coming along here? That's good. Let's See if I can actually get the solder to stick on there somewhere. Well, that's going to work. Try not to cook these too hard because we all know that lithium-ion batteries or lipos or whatever the hell they are can be quite spectacular if they fail from an overheat kind of situation. Now then, some kind of poking stick to hold these down in place. Yes, this is rustic as hell. Get on there. Okay. With my third hand. Oh, come on. Okay, is that going to work? That's kind of in alignment. So now then just heat that guy. Okay, that worked. Just melt the two bulbs of solder together. Okay, man. Why aren't you going down? Well, that's close enough, I think, and okay, that's one in the middle. There we go. Well, that's not spectacular. Now you get down there, you. Oh, wow, that's ugly as hell. That's quite three-dimensional, which is the opposite of what I wanted. Does that still fit in there? Oh, it does. Okay. I'll do the other end off-camera because you've already seen this once. So there's that done. Set those guys aside. I'll just quickly tin up a couple of bits of wire. This is, I don't know, just some random wire that I've got. The link, I don't want it too light. For a lot of lightweight applications, I tend to use telephone wire or something similar to that, maybe Cat 5, but in this application, I think I'm going to use this, which is a little bit heavier, but not too heavy because I don't want to run out of room going up there. Solder this into that mess. Come on, get in there. That brass tab is wicking a lot of heat away. So now then I'll just run that up the side. And so the minus is on that side, the plus is on that side. So I'm going to take it off. Actually, I'm going to take it off from the second battery in. That's just going to be convenient to where the thing is. Okay, now then, do a little bit of tidying up here. That is ugly, but I'm just going to go with it. So now then, will this still fit in there? It does. That's great. Is that going to fit in the box? Let's see. I'm trying really hard not to short those two wires against each other. No, that's not going to fit. Okay, so Won't fit if I run it up there. Is that just jamming up on there? No, what's it jamming on? It's jamming on the batteries. Oh, tape, right. Okay. Which I don't need anymore. Tape getter outer tool. Nope. Not feeling excess heat. That's good. Now then, let's try this. I soldered that one just slightly off skew. Damn it, I was worried about that happening. So, that's what I need to do. It's just refold that solder again and push them back down into alignment. Now then, are we aligned? Pretty good in that direction. Pretty good there. This is, there we go, the age-old trial and error method. The more you watch me, if you can stand to, the more you'll see that that's a large part of how I design things. Okay, so next, I'll need to trim these wires down so that they fit in there. I'm thinking about that for the negative. The positive, I'm going to give it a little bit of room to play there. And I think to solder these in, I'm going to pop that circuit board out. Put the battery pack out. I should not have been so fast to stick that board in there, I guess. Oh well. Excited I was. Mini screwdriver, hello. Possibly too mini. Okay, there we go. So, now then. That sits that way up. Minus, you know what, that sponge is a little dry. There we go, that's more like it. And I do have the copper or brass scrunchy thing over there, which is good too. But I'm old school, I like the sponge. There's that guy tinned, and the positive side. Didn't strip off any more than is absolutely necessary in that one, now did I? Okay. So now then, how am I going to do this? Okay, that's a little suspect, but it's kind of holding in place. Oh, look at that. Beautiful. Now then, when I plug this in, something might happen. Yeah, the little blob of solder on the end that gets in the way is what happens. Okay. Plug you into there. Balance you precariously like that. And bad solder joint. Lack of solder. Good solder joint. Refocus, I wiggled it. There, good solder joint, which isn't the cold solder joint. And, yep. Yeah, no excess flopping around up there. That guy's good. That guy's good. Alrighty then. So, what happens if I push the button? A light. A blinking light. That's awesome! Okay. So, what happens if I get a few things here? Hang on. Okay. Some time passed. My daughter came in to say goodnight to me. So, this guy has some juice in it. According to this, it has 4.95 volts in it. So, using ye olde dollar store charging lead, plug that into the charge input of this guy, which is a stiff. Lights! Bunch of lights. 630 milliamps, 4.9 volts still. 620 milliamps, 630 milliamps. Cool. So that works. Now then, what happens if we go the other way? Ah, you bugger. No, it is that way up. Okay, so that sees a load. That is 5.23 volts. Now let's charge this guy from it. 0.1 amp. 5.22, 0.1 amp. Off. On. 0.1 amp. Oh, wait, there we go. Oh, maybe that's just my janky little cord there. Let's see what happens if I plug it into this very phone here that you're watching me with. Oh, there we go. Full amp. Yahooey. I'd call that a success. Wonder what those do. And if I do that, does nothing. Okay, still. So that's charging my phone at an amp, and it promised that it could put out either 2 amps or 2.1 amps. I'm not sure, I don't speak whatever Asian language that is. I can't tell whether that's in or out, but regardless, into my Note 4, it's pushing 1 amp. At some point, I've got a one of those fancy load USB load things coming. It's not here yet, but I'll be able to do a bit more calibrated tests. But right now, this is great. I'm just gonna unplug my phone from there. Oh, right, it's still, this thing's still presenting a load to it. Okay. There, that's off. That's nice. So, now then, now that it works, I'm going to fit it all into the box. So that has to go like that. Snap in there like that and that. Put that all in place where it's supposed to go. Where's my wooden pokey stick? Poke it down so it's out of the way. You positive wire. Put you over like that. Now then, for a professional Chinese product, you would normally expect things to be held in place with Kapton tape. So, since I got some from the Chinese suppliers, I will do that. You get down there. Now then, anything that I've taken apart so far, the Kapton tape has been slightly askew and cut wrong. So that's just perfect. Makes it look like it actually came from China. Now then, shove him in there. Ta-da. Okay, that still works. Snap him on. Oops. Yeah, baby. And off. There it is. So now, what to do? I guess I should charge it up fully and then discharge it fully. I did say that I don't actually have one of those discharge loads, but somewhere around here I do have some fairly high dissipation resistors, and a USB lead that ends in nothing. So I can put a load on this thing, and using the charger adapter, not that one. This one I think does amp hours. Hello, yeah, this one does milliamp hours. So I can put a load on them with one or more of these resistors. What's this one? 20 watt. Does that say 10 ohms? Doop-a-doop-a-doo. Ohms would be a good range to be on here. Hello. Ten ohms, yeah. So I'll just quickly rig up my test dummy load, and I'll be right back. Since I'm gonna be leaving this bit of scariness unattended running overnight, I decided the most fireproof place that I could put it is right in the middle of a piece of concrete floor. So hopefully nothing bad will happen. Here's hoping. Okay, a couple of days have passed. Didn't catch fire. Actually, this guy didn't even get warm. The resistor got a little bit warm, but I guess you pull 300 milliamps through a 10 ohm resistor, that's going to happen. Anyway, I ran it through two discharge, charge, discharge, charge cycles. And the first one, it looks like it wasn't actually fully charged. I was able to draw 2.149 amp hours out of the battery over a period of 5 hours, and then recharged it. It took 9 hours to fully recharge, a little over 6.5 amp hours, and it charged out of my Vivitar 1000 milliamp charger here. It charged consistently, maxing out around 800 milliamps. So that's, I mean, it could be faster, but that's not too horrendous. I know I can pull a full amp out of this thing, too. I've done it with my phone. So it's just this guy wasn't drawing the full 1 amp that the supply could send. Fair enough, whatever. Anyway, so it took about 9.5 hours, 6,600 milliamp hours. So that took it up to full, and then I immediately put it back onto discharge. This time, from a full charge, it took 8.75 hours, 3.5 amp hours. So that's not too bad. I could definitely charge my phone at least once, probably twice with that. And then to recharge it from where it shut down there, it took, what the hell did I write down there? 747? Okay. And it drew in 5.2 amp hours. So that's not too bad. I mean, especially for just a cheap kit from China. I mean, it's definitely the quality that you buy at a dollar store or whatever. However, the 4 salvaged old laptop batteries, I mean, those laptop batteries are from the same vintage, same lot as this one, so it's 2011. And I know it got used in an office situation, so it would have had dozens, hundreds of charge cycles probably already. So that's not too bad at all, especially for the price paid. I'm going to go with that. Anyway, there we go. Hope you found it interesting. Talk to you later.